Janine and I got married in September of 1989, September 2nd. And I guess about 6 months after that, my dad died of a heart attack. And they say that normally a stressful situation brings lupus out in the patient. And I guess about 2 weeks after my dad died, I remember coming out and Janine was sitting on the couch and just complaining that she was achy. And it was a few months after that that we got the diagnosis. And it just, I remember for me, it just changed everything because she is really my focus. Material things, you know, take a second seat. And that was a big difference that it made for me, was really focusing on being here for her and trying to take more of the weight of family.
It was a shock for me too. I had always been very active. I used to dance, do gymnastics, just always on the go. I was working full-time as a nurse, and it just got to a point where I couldn't even work anymore. I would get up in the morning, and I would have such extreme pain just trying to get dressed and put on my scrubs with such an effort, or even to get into the shower. And it got to a point where I just couldn't do it. I would be calling in every other day, or if it rained, I had to call in. So finally, I decided to resign. And my life is just, it just hasn't been the same. I really enjoyed working. I loved working as a nurse. I did it for as long as I could. I worked full-time for about 15 years after I was diagnosed, and then I went to part-time, and then eventually I had to give it up altogether. I do exercise. I still try to do definitely yoga and things like that and stretching. And when I feel really good, I do take classes. I'll go to the gym and just take regular dance classes. When you're in pain, the thing that you want to do is just lay around and not do anything, just curl up in a ball and stay like that. But I found that if I get up and at least do some simple stretches, things like that, I do feel a lot better. Okay. In the beginning, I used to get annoyed. My husband would try to get me off the couch, and you know, when I was first diagnosed, and why don't you just lift some light weights or do some stretching? And I was like, leave me alone, I just want to lay here. But in reality, it does help to do exercise. Being a mother with lupus is really difficult because it's hard to plan things. I really have to go day to day. I don't plan things months ahead, or I just have to go by how I feel, how the weather is. Right now, my lupus has been pretty quiet, so I'm able to do things with them, but it's just very unpredictable. And it's harder for the little one. My daughter, she doesn't understand on days when I'm really feeling bad and I don't want to do something with her. You know, she kind of takes it personally that, you know, why don't you want to take me to the park, or why don't you want to do this, or why can't we run? Especially when we have school trips. Sometimes I can't do school trips because of the bus ride and how long it is. It's difficult for them.
When we first met, and I think we were at Adelphi one day, and I said, let's go running. And she says, well, running hurts. And it was such a strange and foreign statement to me because I just could not understand it. But of course now it makes sense.
Yeah, and I used to run. I ran track in junior high school, and in high school is pretty much when I stopped because it did hurt. I didn't know why, but it just hurt to run.
Some of the things you read said that it was basically a death sentence.
Yeah, even in my nursing book, one of my nursing textbooks, I read in there and it said the job of the nurse is to prepare the family for the poor prognosis. So I pretty much thought I was gonna die.
You know, dealing with family members was difficult. I remember my mother-in-law saying that if something were to happen to you during childbirth, that she wouldn't want to see the baby. And so it, you know, it affects everybody. It affects everybody differently.
Yeah, my family was definitely against us trying to have kids because, you know, they were afraid of what the outcome was going to be and what kind of damage it was going to do to me. So we did wait a long time. We didn't have our first child till I was 30, but that was after talking to a lot of doctors and a lot of specialists, and everybody assured me that it could be done. told that there's only like a 5% chance that, you know, my kids might develop lupus. I did ask their pediatrician about that because, you know, immediately I wanted them tested, and he said they don't necessarily test for lupus unless they're showing symptoms. If they're showing symptoms or complaining of something, then they would start running blood work, but they don't just randomly test. I do have autoimmune disease in my family. My mother has diabetes, her mother, my grandmother has rheumatoid arthritis. So we do have different forms of autoimmune disease, but no one in my family has lupus. And there's five of us, five kids, and nobody has anything like this. I contacted the Lupus Alliance, and from then I was able to get some up-to-date information. And, you know, talking to my doctors, he told me not to read anything beyond 10 years old because things are constantly changing. And, you know, 20, 30 years ago, that basically is what happened. You got a rash, your kidneys failed, and you died. So now I just make sure that I keep up to date with all the new information, and I try to educate other people as well as my family and friends.
She is my focus, my kids. That's my responsibility, I feel, to take care of them. And it's difficult because on one hand, I want to be outside, possibly making more money to do things. But I also need to be here to help with things around the house. Wash clothes, wash dishes, cook,
he does
clean.
It all. I'm very lucky. And doesn't complain about it either. After I had resigned my job, basically I was just bored to tears. I didn't know what to do with myself during the day, and I just felt so helpless and useless. And one day, I forget who it was, I think Joanne had called me and said they were starting a new thing called Lupus Line, where they were going to train people with lupus to help other people over the phone. So like people who were shut in or didn't like, you know, large groups for support, we could talk to them one-on-one and help them, especially newly diagnosed people. So I went through the 8-week training and I started doing that, and it's really been great. It helps me a lot because I feel like I'm helping other people.
We have a babysitter named Janice, who's no longer a babysitter, but more of like a family member. And she has picked the kids up and done things with them. There are even a couple of women who have a cleaning service, and they've come by and they all bring gifts for the kids around the holidays, mm-hmm. call and check up and see how we're doing. And
even my neighbor, she moved now, but Alexa had told her I was in the hospital, and I was only in for a couple of days. It wasn't, you know, anything major. And she dropped by with a basket from the local pizzeria with a gift certificate for us to have dinner so we didn't have to cook, and things like that.